everyone. My name is Catherine Skaggs. I am the marketing manager for Bon Voyage Travel. If you've tuned into any of our past webinars, then you would have probably seen our president, Ryan Hansen, do this introduction. Unfortunately, he's not able to make it today, so I'm going to take a stab at it, so bear with me. First off, let's talk about you're all muted, so we can't hear you. So if you have any questions, please feel free to type them into the question box that's down below in the Zoom toolbar, and then we'll address all of the questions at the end. Also note that these webinars are recorded, so if you miss something and you'd like to rewatch it, or maybe you know someone that could benefit from this webinar, please go to bvtravel.com/events, and you'll find all of our recorded webinars there. So now let's talk about why you've tuned in today, small ship cruising with star clippers. And why did we name it that? I think because we're all very cognizant of this new world that we live in where we're aware of crowds. And what's nice about star clippers is that each ship only holds about 200 guests. So I look at it as like you can physically distance without having to socially distance. And with their tall clipper ships, your experience on board is going to be unique more than any other cruising that you could, that you'll find out there. It's a very unique experience. So I want to hand it over to Beth, who can give you a better look at how unique they are. I want to introduce Beth. She is the business development manager for Star Clippers, who will give us a much deeper look at why they're so unique. So Beth, it's all yours.
Thank you, Catherine. Good afternoon, everyone. Delighted to have you join us today to find out and learn more about an incredible vacation experience called Star Clippers. I'm going to ask you, for anyone that has cruised before, doesn't matter what the line, doesn't matter what the size of the ship, I need you to actually turn that information in your mind completely off. This afternoon is about Star Clippers' authentic sailing experience, and not a typical cruise. So sit back, relax, and enjoy, and delighted to have you here with us today. Imagine yourself on the teak deck of a timelessly elegant clipper ship. A warm breeze is blowing softly. And in the background, Vangelis' 1492 Conquest to Paradise is playing as the captain and his crew unfurl 54,000 square feet of sail above you. You begin to tingle from head to toe. And as you sail into the sunset onto tomorrow's next hidden cove, you sigh when you realize this is the most incredible experience I've ever had. Now please join me on board. To share with you, this gets my heart racing. I know we've all been cooped up and quarantined in our own homes, etc., and I'm just yearning, truly yearning to be back on board the Star Clipper ships. So a little bit about me, just so you can put it in perspective. I come from a big ship background, although I do have small ship background as well. I didn't know a thing about clipper ships. I signed on the dotted line with Star Clippers 4 years ago. And first time I ever stepped on board after I signed on with the company, I was totally blown away at how amazing and incredible this experience is. So for the next moment, what I'd like to do is share with you why you might want to consider Star Clippers, what makes her so uniquely different. As I mentioned, first and foremost, we are authentic sailing. What this means is that the primary propulsion of the ship is actually by the wind. And what that means is that you've got a completely different journey taking you very up close and personal to these amazing itineraries around the world without the lines, without the crowds, and without being in places where you do have those big ships and thousands of people that pour off of them and are in your way and surrounding you everywhere you go. So again, a unique experience being on board near replicas of the clipper ships from 1900s. We're a privately held company, and this is the passion of our owner, Mr. Kraft, Mikael Kraft, a Swedish man, entrepreneur, lawyer by trade, but also a yachtsman. And his goal in building these three ships in our fleet, yes, he built them, he owns them, was to bring the golden age of sailing back to today's vacationing public. We've been around for a little over 30 years, but again, this may be a new type of vacation experience that you're learning about today. So with that said, we actually uniquely then build the itineraries on the wind charts. This gives us the opportunity 70 to 90% of the time on average of an actual sailing experience. And as I mentioned a moment ago, it is the primary propulsion of the ship. Not to worry, however, we'll never be stuck in the water, not going anywhere. We certainly have an environmentally friendly engine. If we need to be able to stay on schedule, perhaps we don't have as much wind or the right wind to get us where we need to go and stay on schedule, we absolutely will augment, but it's not the primary way for us to propel the ship. And I'm not a sailor. I didn't grow up that way. I'm learning to become one, and I truly love the unique experiences that are available on board related to sailing. So for example, climbing the midship mast, hanging out in the bowsprit netting, the netting you see behind me, for example, which is out at the bow of the ship, or helping to set the sails. And that's what our open bridge policy allows our guests to do on board. But we're casual, we're relaxed, so no jackets and ties required on board. And Michelin trained chefs, you're going to dine very, very well. 2-to-1 guest to staff ratio means that we have highly personalized service. You will know our captain, you will know our officers. They'll be very visible throughout the sailing, and you're welcome to speak with them and enjoy talking with them and interact, et cetera. The destinations and the itineraries that we build are also uniquely different in that, yes, we know what those bucket list destinations, those treasures that people are seeking, such as Dubrovnik, it might be Rome or Venice, maybe it's Bali or Singapore, or maybe it's St. Lucia or Bridgetown, Barbados. So we have those types, all those itineraries that include those great ports, but by unique virtue of the fact that we're small, we're not a big cruise ship, we can go to those hidden coves, we can go more of the Greek islands and along the coastline of Croatia and throughout the islands in Indonesia, the big ships cannot do. And that allows for this amazing, not only sailing experience for you, but these exquisite destinations that we're sharing, which I'll introduce to you in a few minutes. Simply said, we're casual, relaxed, and very intimate. So as Catherine mentioned, the two ships are 170 guests only, and our third ship's only 227 guests. And if you will, it's like a private yacht-like experience on a tall ship. Who sails with us? Lots of people sail with us. We're perfect for those travelers that are social, they're outgoing, they continue to be active in their lifestyle, they want to see more of the world, they might want a particular area of the world to be more culturally immersed or greater insight to the history of those particular locations. Maybe there is a true preference for this particular vacation experience, or maybe always to be casual and relaxed. Those that are looking for few guests, a more intimate, up-close type of vacation experience. But it's all ages, and I'm personally here to say that it's adventure in your heart. It's not your actual age. It's noted on the screen, our average age on board is about 45 to 55, but we see the whole gamut. You've got the millennials who love the adventure and the spirit and the uniqueness of this type of vacation. And you have guests in their early 80s and mid 80s still traveling with us simply because they love us. And again, they're there to relax and enjoy, and they appreciate this experience. You could be traveling with your family. Maybe it's a multi-generational reunion, all types of celebratory reasons to be on board, honeymoons, birthdays, retirements, just, hey, I want to have fun. Certainly, if you are a water enthusiast, maybe you own your own boat, yacht club members, they, of course, enjoy this experience because they're loving the water and the boating experience already. We do see a crossover of all types of vacations. So guests that are introduced to a more intimate experience, like those that have been on river boats, even those that have been on other types of cruises, maybe those that are doing more unique types of vacations, whether it's a safari or Galapagos or Alaska. So again, a lot of crossover, but when you're looking for that casual, relaxed, and something uniquely different, Star Clippers fits the bill very, very well. We do actually source our business from across Northern Europe, primarily, and throughout North America. And so you have a great mix of continental guest mix on board the ship. English is always our primary language, and about 80% or more of our guests are speaking English already. So again, a very, very enjoyable experience. One of the things that attracted me to Star Clippers, and something that makes me very proud in representing the brand, is that over 60% of our guests repeat within the first year. So not just in general, but people are so loving this experience, memorable trip of a lifetime, that they come back and they sail time and time again. So we hope you will try and return as well. Let me introduce you to the fleet of ships. Our two original ships are Star Clipper and Star Flyer. And let me put this in perspective. While they look rather, maybe small, if you will, in this image, those ships are actually a football field long. So I love personally to think of myself sitting in a stadium where our ship is sitting end to end zone, end zone to end zone, right there in the middle of the field. In a moment, I'll share with you how large the third ship is. But you'll know these two ships because they are four-masted, fully rigged. They are of the barkentine style of clipper ships, if you will. And again, beautiful sailing experience, but only 170 guests and 85 cabins on board. Sharing a little bit of the interior of the ship with you, there are both places out on deck that are out under the sun as well as covered, but there's also beautiful interior shots like the Edwardian Library, like the tropical bar, piano lounge areas where you can see the sea, you can see the activity outside, and yet you're in a cool interior. Very spacious ships, over 19,000 square feet of teak decking on two decks, the public areas, outdoors, as well as inside. So lots of places to relax and enjoy privately and or be outdoors with others. The Clipper dining room, we have spa treatments and areas secluded on the ship where you can have a massage and enjoy. And we include our complimentary water sports, such as snorkeling, kayaking, paddleboarding, even some windsurfing, sailboating, and sometimes even water skiing. Excuse me. A variety of cabin category choices that fit a nice range of budgets, although in general, we provide an extremely good value to our clients. We do have an owner's cabin. We have 8 deluxe ocean view cabins, so very beautiful, very spacious, full picture windows. One of the reasons we're not a typical sail is that on an authentic sailing vessel, portholes are A-OK. So in most of the cabins, they are a porthole as your ocean view, as well as just a small handful of interior cabins as well. So something not only to fit a variety of budgets, but different locations throughout the ship. And well-appointed, lots of efficiency in space and storage, and beautifully appointed and nice nautical colors. Next, I'd like to introduce you to the flagship of our fleet. This is the Royal Clipper. You will know her because she's fully rigged 5-masted, and she's the largest fully rigged 5-masted ship in the entire world today, as noted in the Guinness Book of World Records. This ship is a football field and a half long. And part of the reason I share with you the largesse of the ship is not only to appreciate the spaciousness and the intimate number of guests on board, but also sometimes when we say sailing, there's sort of that question mark of stability. And I want to ensure you know that we're very stable. We hug coastlines. We don't have a casino on board, so we're not 3 to 6 miles out in the open waters. And the ship is built like a sailing passenger vessel. So we've got a deep draft. We sit down deep in the water, held down with the keel. We have the water ballast that keep the side-by-side movement very, very stable. And of course, that incredible adept captain and his crew. This ship is more modern in style and feel. She is the near replica of the Prison from 1902 and nice amenities throughout. Looking at the interior of the ship, there is, again, that more modern style and feel that you can see with a three-deck high atrium and the clipper dining room there at the base. On this ship, there's three swimming pools. On the two original ships, there's two. And that skylight that you see on the left is actually the base of the midship pool. So I love to kid my guests and say, I dare you to skinny dip. This ship does have an actual fitness center and the Captain Nemo spa area. So again, we're able to offer spa treatments and massages on board. And again, the beautiful interior spaces, such as the tropical and piano bar interior areas, as well as the outdoor decks. Again, a nice variety of cabin category choices on board the ship for 114 cabins and only 227 guests. Most of the categories are ocean view in a category 2 through 5. Again, portholes. This is the ship, however, that have 14 deluxe suites with a private veranda. So if you are a cruiser and you appreciate a balcony, if you simply would prefer a greater amount of space in your own personal area on board the ship, then the 14 deluxe verandas suites are perhaps your choice. We also have 2 owner suites on board. Those are the only cabins on board that actually hold 4 guests, and they also connect. So perhaps think in terms of traveling with family or friends where you can be close in accommodations together. On all 3 ships, we have double occupancy as well as triple occupancy and the ability then to capture families and traveling together. What I love about the smooth sailing experience is, again, a combination and a variety of entertainment and activities for everyone. Certainly, you have the unique activities such as the midship mast climb, which you see here in the middle of the screen. You also have the opportunity to hang out in the bowsprit, which is there on the left bottom, the opportunity to set sails, take the helm, and as a full working ship, of course, if we tear a sail, we've got that sewing machine right on board to take advantage of it. And as I mentioned, the marina, the water complimentary water sports that are included on all 3 ships, whether we launch them from the marina deck aft on the Royal Clipper, or simply from the beach or from the Zodiac when we're on the other 2 ships. But other types of activities our guests enjoy on board are things like a crew and guest talent show, fashion show. We will always have a musician with a keyboard and music and dancing in the evenings after dinner. If we're in port late at night, we will bring folkloric entertainment from that area to the ship for us to enjoy. Perhaps you might want to stargaze with our second engineer, or learn how to track and follow the stars. So a nice variety of things to take advantage of and or simply know that they're there and build your itinerary and your time on board the ship, on and off the ship the way that you would like. Certainly we offer shore excursions and you can take advantage of those, as well as opportunities in most locations on many of the itineraries to simply do your own thing, if you will. Let me share with you some of the incredible destinations that we sail around the globe. On this slide, really what I want to share with you is the fact that the Royal Clipper, so the flagship and one of the original ships, they actually move according to the seasonality. These ships will be in the Caribbean during the winter months. So in that November, December, January, February, March timeframe, which wherever we might be living is kind of that time of the year where you say, wow, I really want to get away, or maybe the weather is just, you know, I just need a break. And so we're in the warm waters. Then come the spring and the fall, we actually transit those ships from deep in the Caribbean all the way across the Atlantic Ocean. So we sell our transatlantic crossings in the spring and the fall. And those are the 2 ships that sail a very beautiful long season in the Mediterranean from late April to late November. Our third ship, Star Clipper, one of the original ships, actually is based in Southeast Asia year-round. She too moves with the weather. So in the summer months, the ship is in Bali and Indonesia area because that is the right time for the weather and the beautiful peak season. And then from November to April, the right time to be in Thailand and Malaysia, as well as Singapore and Borneo and Cambodia, is during that particular time frame. So while she's there year round, she actually will move according to the weather as well. But let's look further at these amazing destinations. In the Caribbean, the Royal Clipper sails from Bridgetown, Barbados, and 1 week she will sail 7 nights to the Windward Islands, followed the next week 7 nights to the Grenadine Islands. The other ship, Star Flyer, will sail from Phillipsburg, St. Martin, alternating between the Leeward Islands 1 week, followed by the next week on the Treasure Islands, are also known as the British Virgin Islands. Sail them 7 nights or put them back to back and enjoy an amazing area of the world. So we're going to the more idyllic islands. We're not going to where the big ships are. All we have to do is drop anchor or perhaps port right at a local dock. I've been in itineraries where we've even docked street side and been able to walk off the ship. But by virtue of the fact that we can literally be very, very close and not have to be in a port itself, no matter where we sail, is that neat opportunity to be very, very up close and enjoy a much different view and way to experience all these amazing places around the globe. One of the things that's incredible about the Caribbean itineraries, every other week, the two ships actually meet. And as they are headed towards Cabri, Dominica, the ships actually race. So nothing is more fun and exhilarating than being out on deck with your fellow guests and urging your crew and your captain to actually, you know, I don't know, as much as possible, you know, move and race, if you will. So it's a great time. It's very enjoyable. And I think it's unique in that you can see the other ship where, again, when you're on one of the ships, you're not always seeing the other parts of the fleet. So something our guests very much enjoy. As we transit and come into the Mediterranean, we start the season coming in through generally Malaga, Spain, and in through the Balearic Islands as the ship makes its way to one of its first ports of call, which is Cannes, France. We do round-trip Cannes itinerary 7 nights. We do also Cannes to Rome 7 nights. And this will primarily take in the gorgeous French Riviera areas like Monaco, Saint-Tropez, Portofino, Elba, unique places. Again, not necessarily where the big ships are, but certainly the gorgeous areas that we want to go to, combined, for example, with Corsica, which is very rich in history, like Bonifacio, as you see here. We also sail from Rome, round trip 7 nights, that'll take in the Amalfi Coast. And one of the things that I want to share with you about Rome is that every ship in the world sails from there. We sail on a Saturday, and I'll never forget thinking, wow, I'm going to the port, and I'm going to see every large cruise ship there. Well, the beautiful thing about it is we sail at sunset. Every single ship was gone, and it was just the Royal Clipper and the Star Flyer in port, and we sailed at sunset. So again, I'm trying to share with you the fact that it's totally not a typical cruise. You're not around the big ships, and again, just an amazing experience, unlike anything else. As you're looking at these particular pictures, I hope you get a sense for how close that we can be to where we sail. We can simply drop anchor right outside the walled city of Kres, Croatia. We actually do sail the Grand Canal in Venice because we can. We're small. When we dock, we actually dock closest to the main attractions in St. Mark's Square. The big cruise ships are much further down in the docking area. So again, thoroughly enjoyable and a different viewpoint. Throughout the Mediterranean itineraries, we sail also round trip from Athens on glorious 7-night Greek island itineraries. So yes, we have the fan favorites of Mykonos as well as Santorini, but we cover over 25 different ports in the Greek islands, Hydra, Amorgos, Patmos, Monavasia, Katakalon, Nafplio, and more. So again, that rich Greek heritage in the islands where they're not overly touristy. And again, just that glorious turquoise water and wonderful experience. Spetses, the bottom right-hand corner, happens to be a Greek island that celebrities go to, or the more affluent in the Europeans. And the mode of transportation on the island is by horse and buggy and or bicycles or by foot. So no cars allowed on the island. Skoklios that you see to the bottom left is part of our Sporades highlights itineraries. And if you recognize that church on the top, that is where they filmed the church scene for the wedding in Mamma Mia 1. So again, you've got lots of choice of the Greek islands. We do quite a bit of the Greek islands as well as Croatia. And while we do each of those areas in 7-night itineraries, we also have highly popular 10 and 11 night sailings that combine Italy, Croatia, and Montenegro, or Greece, Montenegro, and Croatia. The third ship, as I mentioned, sails year-round in the Far East. And these are itineraries I personally have been on, and they are incredibly, absolutely mind-blowing, beautiful, and amazing. Not only, again, for that rich history, but just unique experiences. These itineraries are built anywhere from 7 nights, 10 and 11 nights, and even up to 14 nights. They tend to be a little bit more of soft adventure or more adventuresome in general. Many of the places on our itineraries, we're actually going to places where they don't normally see tourists. So we have built shore excursions that our guests can take advantage of and see and do the culture and enjoy the people and your interior areas. And so uniquely different all the way around. One of the other features about the Southeast Asia itineraries is that if you happen to be a certified scuba diver, we have an independent contractor that's on the ship on every sailing, every itinerary, certified PADI instructor. So for a small fee, you are more than welcome to take advantage of these glorious waters, unique areas to go ahead and scuba dive, in addition to, of course, the complimentary water sports. In Indonesia in the summer, we alternate between a 7-night eastbound itinerary that allows us to go to the Gili Islands, Lombok Island. The Gili Islands are the small islands, if you will. And right in the heart of that particular itinerary is Komodo National Park, that amazing dragon. Some people truly have that on their bucket list. I haven't quite decided where it is on my list, but I'm adventuresome, so at some point I will do that itinerary. And then the westbound itinerary, which is a combination of off the beaten path, culturally immersive opportunities, as well as the wonderful beach and water sports and Gili Island types of experiences. So very rich and beautiful. Now what I'd like to do is let you know that there's really a variety of promotional offers to fit everyone's budget and the itineraries that they would like to sail. And the purpose of this particular slide is simply to let you know that they're there and available, but it's your specialists at Bon Voyage Travel that will certainly navigate all that detail with you as they explore the itineraries and the dates, et cetera, of what you would like to do for your next vacation. For solo travelers, we have many, many dates where we waive the single supplement, so it's a great value. Whether even you're traveling with others and just simply want your own accommodations or truly traveling on your own. Hotel packages, for example, maybe it's air credit, onboard credit, or choose your perks. Maybe you're a first responder or an essential worker. We've got something that really addresses some opportunity for all. The other thing that I'd like you to keep in mind is if you have a handful of cabins and or think you might be at some point, 5 cabins or 10 guests, we'd love to have you discuss with your Bon Voyage travel specialist the group policy and take a look and see what we can put together for you in terms of great amenities and group rates. We also have an exclusive offer that we'd like to share with you. This offer is a $200 onboard credit per cabin. It's combinable with almost every promotion that we currently have in the marketplace. And this special offer is in place between today and the end of June. So we have almost 3 weeks to ponder the itinerary and dates with your specialist and make your reservation with this additional amenity. To note, the deposit to hold a cabin with your name is only $400 per person, and we refer to it as no risk because truly there is a no risk. You may cancel up to 120 days prior to sailing without any type of penalty. So I share that with you because, again, no matter what cabin category, no matter what itinerary, it's a low fee per person just to simply hold your cabin with name and plan and dream for that next vacation in the near future. What's new? I wanted to let you know that currently we are published through March of 2022. And very soon, in just a few weeks, we will be publishing all the way through November of 2022. And what this means is that summer Mediterranean season will be then open from April to November, as well as the Southeast Asia itineraries that include the summer Indonesia Bali from Bali itineraries, the spring and the fall crossings, and the Cambodia, Borneo, Thailand, and Singapore sailings for the latter part of 2022 as well. In wrapping this up, I just wanted to share with you a quote from one of our passengers, and I've got to move something here. "Truly no experience as thrilling as a clipper ship. The sail away is magical, the food is awesome, the staff is fabulous. Once you've sailed a clipper, you'll never go back to the big ships. It's sailing is for your heart and your soul." I personally know that to be true. It's an amazing, unbelievably exhilarating experience. I just wanted you to have one last glimpse of this amazing vacation experience. I want to say personally thank you for joining Catherine and I this afternoon. Please reach out to your Bon Voyage travel specialist for anything Star Clippers. And I'm going to turn it back to Catherine because I think there may be some questions.
Yes, thank you, Beth. That was fantastic. This is why we leave the presenting up to the pros like yourself and not me doing this. So thank you for that. We had a couple of questions. First off, I just was hoping that you'd talk a little bit more about the water sports. You had mentioned the water sports and the scuba diving. What other water sports can we expect that might be included, actually?
Well, the water sports that are included, we offer snorkeling, kayaking, paddleboarding, windsurfing, sailboating, and water skiing. Certainly the best opportunities to do those types of activities, of course, are on the Caribbean itineraries because lots of water and so forth, as well as certainly through Southeast Asia. Yes, they're available on the Mediterranean itineraries. It's just simply going to depend on the waters, if you will, that we're sailing in. The scuba diving is available for a small fee. We have 15 sets of equipment on board. So what you're paying for is actually the tank. And this is something that you can just simply come on board and spend time and, you'll meet the independent contractor, the PADI certified instructor, and any fees, if you do decide to dive, will just simply be put on your house account.
Great. Thank you. We have a question about the portholes. Do the cabin portholes open for fresh air?
They do not. Can you imagine that if for any reason the water was moving or we were moving through the water and it splashed? You certainly don't want your room to flood with water. So they don't actually open. But what's nice is the ships are only four decks high. So to reach the public areas and be outdoors is very, very close at hand, truly.
And just wonderful to have them on board for the sunlight, for the view, to just have.
Absolutely. One of my favorite experiences, quite honestly, was sailing from the coastline, from Sorrento. We were sailing to Sicily, and I happened to open my curtain when I rose in the morning, and there was Stromboli, the volcano, right in front of me, huge. So yes, it's a great opportunity to Amazing. See where you are, what the weather's like, etc.
Yeah. Let's see, another question. If you anchor offshore, how do you get to shore for an excursion, for example?
Perfect question. We carry our own tender boats, which means that when we do anchor, we're generally very, very close. So we're talking about a short tender ride, and we actually will board our guests into the tender and take them to either the beach and or to the dock where we will disembark. And they will run every half hour to and from the ship, and that'll be identified in the daily planner so you know when we'll begin and when the last one coming back to the ship will be.
Perfect. Are your ships accessible for seniors with walkers?
Thank you for bringing that up. I didn't expand on that, and I meant to. We like to refer to the guest's need as being mobile, because mobility has to do with getting up and down a gangway on and off the ship, which can be very steep, even though the ship's only four decks high. There are no elevators on board, and therefore you do have to feel comfortable in climbing up and down stairs. Now, while I'm not talking about, you know, 25 stairs or 100 stairs, it might be 8 to 10 stairs to go from the main deck up to the sun deck. So sure-footedness and an ability to be able to, again, manage the stairs and things like that really is a personal type of thing. I know guests have come on board with canes. Perhaaps they've been on board with walkers, but I really think it's a personal decision, as well as the captain's decision, honestly. Have that conversation with the Bon Voyage travel specialist you work with for us to really understand, is this the type of experience that will work well for you?
Great, thank you. Last question. You mentioned the 2-to-1 crew to guest ratio. Can you kind of expand on the importance of this in terms of service?
Great question. I'm glad to do that. What you want is non-intrusive service, but responsive service. And so by virtue of the fact that for every 2 guests on board, there's essentially 1 employee or part of the crew or part of our Star Clipper staff, there's always someone there to assist you, whether it's to answer a question or the ship, you know, as I've mentioned, is relatively small. You will know your captain because he will introduce you. You will see him throughout the day. You'll see him on the bridge. You'll see the officers. You'll know who your cruise director is, who the scuba diver instructor is. They'll introduce the sports team. And generally when that happens is generally later, about 10:30 in the morning on the second day you're on board the ship. Once we complete one of the safety drills, the captain gathers guests, and that's when we introduce the staff. So it's really to let you know that if there's something you need or if you have a question, you don't have to go, you know, seek high and low. We're always going to be there to assist in any way we can.
Wonderful. Well, thank you, Beth. That's pretty much all of the questions that we have. Thank you so much for your time. We're very grateful for your time. For everyone that is in the audience, if you think of any questions, please reach out to a travel advisor, a Bon Voyage travel advisor, and we're happy to help you. So remember to check out bbtravel.com/events, and there you will see this recorded webinar along with others. And you can also look at our calendar of events for future webinars. Next week, we're going to be doing a destination-driven webinar on Alaska. So you'll definitely want to register for that. So thanks again, Beth, and thank you all, and have a great day.
Thank you very much. Enjoy, all. Hope to see you on board.